Have you ever wanted to make a video intro stylized to a retro computer screen? Well, in this tutorial, we're going to take a look at exactly how to do that using only Camtasia. Let's get started. The basic idea behind this effect is pretty straightforward. We need to create some block text, pixelate it a bit, and give it that classic green CRT glow. Let's start with our text. Go over to the Annotations tab and add a text annotation to your canvas. We'll resize the bounding box for the annotation, as this will make it easier to customize later. Highlight your text and change it to whatever you want. I'll use video game for now. We'll resize our text so that it fills up our bounding box again. Now comes a bit of magic. To make our block text, we're actually going to make three copies of our text annotation, lay them on top of each other, and offset them just a bit. Each time you paste a new text annotation, shift it up and to the left. Great. Now let's change the color of all three annotations. We're going to shoot for the green color of an old CRT monitor. Remember that the color was created by electrons hitting a phosphor screen, so we actually want to mix some white in as well. Okay, now we're going to grab a media mat and apply it to our middle text annotation layer, which is going to generate our block look. By default, your mode will probably be set to alpha, which doesn't look quite right, so go ahead and switch it to alpha invert. Much better. Now that we have our media mat applied, let's go back and adjust our positioning one more time. Just move each of the layers until you get the effect you're looking for. Okay, next up, let's add our glow. We want to add this glow to really sell the effect of that electron beam hitting the back of the display. Go back to your visual effects and add the glow effect to both your top and bottom text annotation layers. Be careful not to add it to the middle layer, as this will interfere with our media mat. Set the glow radius to around 10 and the intensity to around 50. That gives us a nice soft glow. Okay, the text is almost there, but it's still missing something. The text is just a bit too sharp, so we're going to add one more effect to our top and bottom text annotations. Go find the mosaic effect and apply it to your annotations. Turn the intensity way down so that the effect is more subtle. Something around 12% should do. One thing to keep in mind is that the mosaic effect is only available on Camtasia for Mac at the moment. If you're on Camtasia for Windows, you can get a similar effect by using the pixelate annotation and placing it on a track above your text annotation. Okay, let's group our annotations just to keep things neat and tidy. This will also set us up to make this into a quick property asset a little later. Now, we could stop here, but we're on a roll, so let's add some more detail. In the real world, black colors are rarely pure black, and for our screen, let's add some light scatter to the display. The easiest way to do this is to grab a rectangular annotation, put it on the canvas, and stretch it to fill the entire canvas. Change the color to a similar green as our text. Then, set the opacity way down to around 10%. Great. To bring things home, let's add a bit of action to our screen, just to really sell the effect. Back in the day, computers lacked a lot of the rendering power that we have today, so animation was pretty simple, generally just basic fades and wipes, with a pretty low frame rate. We could use this bar wipe transition, but it's a bit disjointed. Fortunately, there's a great transition hiding in the fade section called random bars. This one looks great. Random dissolve is also a great one to try for a similar effect, but I think we'll stick with random bars this time. Okay, one last bit of action. Let's simulate our screen turning on. Once again, we'll turn to our transitions and grab the glitch transition. This one is really cool and does a great job of simulating the display being turned on and quickly warming up. And finally, let's turn all of this into a quick property asset. Camtasia already helpfully did the bulk of the work when we turned this into a group, but we don't necessarily want to edit the text three times because it might break our effect, and it's just annoying to do. Let's go into the Quick Property Editor and chain our three text annotations together. When we do this, the text fields will be linked together, which means we only need to edit one field to change the entire effect. There, much easier. And there you have it, your very own 80s computer screen effect. This is really cool to use along with a retro device frame, and it's great for advertisements and other creative productions. Hopefully that was helpful. If so, make sure to like and subscribe for more Camtasia tutorials. Thanks for watching.